Now, if you're looking to create a mock scrape this year, there's some very basic and easy steps that you can follow to get the job done, and it's probably a whole lot easier than you think. But I'm gonna talk about some of the basics. Been creating mock scrapes, natural mock scrapes, since early 2000s, and they're one of my favorite types of improvements that you can put a, not only put a camera on, but we actually have a stand right back here too. Nearly all my stand setups, if there's two or if there's one, there's a mock scrape nearby, and most of mine you shoot with a bow, and this one's no exception. In fact, the camera's right here. We have the camera, the tree stand, everything set up to watch this movement. Very important, very hot habitat improvement that you can add to your land, and again, very easy to get the job done. This is, I use a mock vine. We have lots of vines around here, so I'm using a vine licking branch for a scrape. I like vertical hanging mock scrapes. Very important. I like these at waist high. You can see this one is right at waist high for me. And the reason for that, we'll just start with this, is the bottom of the height of the scrape, then every fawn, every doe, every young buck, and every mature buck that goes right through this bench system, which is where we've seen that they go all the time. We have trails during the off season, in season scouting, but every deer that comes through here will leave its scent on this licking branch, the preorbital glands by their eye. Every fawn too. So we have lots of video of fawns coming through, hitting our mock scrapes. And then the next thing, scent. You don't need to put any other scent on this mock vine scrape. I've been using these for years. Maybe there's a man-made scent out there that's better than natural scent, that's better than the accumulation of dozens of deer preorbital gland scent that the deer leave on there. But I haven't found one. There might be one out there. I'm not saying there's not. But it's very hard to argue with natural scent. And so this mock vine we actually took from another property, and it already has dozens of deer scent on it from the last 2 years, and the accumulation even from when we took it. So I'm not sure how much scent is on here, but it's only been about a couple weeks from the other property. So we're putting it back out. We're really careful not to touch this bottom 2 feet of the vine scrape. Now, another point, I like these vertical vines. I like them to be 5 to 6 feet long. And I would imagine this one's right in between that. I want that, and I also want 3/4 inch to 1 inch in diameter. There's a few reasons for that. For one, it's not gonna be blowing around in the wind like a rope. Don't use hemp rope, don't use natural rope, unnatural rope. It's not heavy enough, and it's not natural. So think of those deer, they wanna press their preorbital glands on there. If it's just a lightweight rope, it's pretty difficult for them to do so. It's blowing out around in the wind. We use quality trail cameras, Exodus trail cameras. If you use a non-quality trail camera, it might pick up the movement from that rope or light stick blowing around in the wind. We like one single 5 to 6 foot branch or vine, 3/4 inch to 1 inch in diameter. That's about the right weight. We have about 2 feet of rope attached to a branch up there so it can swing around naturally as if it was a vine hanging from the tree. If you don't have vines natural to your area, I would encourage you to use a white oak branch, a jack pine branch, a beech tree branch, even an aspen branch or a popple branch in areas where you don't have those others, and then finally a red cedar branch. Those are all great scraping trees naturally. You take that branch off, take all the branches off of that branch, and hang it just like you're seeing with this vine. I like these vertical branches again because if you're putting that traditional height right here, a lot of times you're off to the side of the movement, and that's under or above the fawns, small does are under that branch. If you put this hanging vine right in the middle of the trail system, which this one is, every deer that goes through here is going to sniff this. It's going to leave its scent, and that accumulation of scent is just a wealth of goodness when it comes to making sure that every buck that's in this area right here, 30 yards, 40 yards on either side, when they're traveling this entire bench system that's 1/4 mile to 1/2 mile long, they'll just slant that movement a little bit to come by and hit this mock scrape during the day. We've used just natural nylon cord to attach it to the branch up there. So just a rope, a vine or a branch. We clear this out into about a 3-4 foot diameter. When we leave, I'll actually urinate into the scrape. I don't even know if that really matters or not. I know it doesn't bother the deer at all, but it's something that we do. The urine, human urine smells like animal urine within 20 minutes. It all breaks down. It's not going to bother the deer in any way. So we'll add that at the end, but I clear out a pretty large area. I want a buck that's over here 20 yards to look down, see this big patch of dirt and know there's something here. We put a camera on it. We have a tree stand nearby. We can change the card when we hunt the stand. Pretty easy to get in and out of this one. This mock vine scrape has a lot of purpose for where it's located. I want you to do the same. What kind of story does this mock vine tell you within the location? For example, we have a field edge up here. Deer are moving to the parallel of the field edge. This is a natural bench system that's flat. Bucks cruise this area in the morning because they can scent check from below with all the rising thermals. We have a man-made bedding area, hinge cut bedding area over here. We have another mock scrape about 200 yards away. We have a new water hole that we're adding around the corner over here about 150 yards away. Bedding area on the point over there, bedding area on the point over here. So we're in this bow tie movement where lots of bedding, other mock scrapes, water holes. There's a lot of reason for deer to be moving through this area. And that's that story I'm talking about. What does your location tell you? What kind of story, what kind of features are coming together to create a larger story of why bucks might potentially be moving through the area that you're putting mock scrape? And of course, that makes a perfect spot for a tree stand location. I urge you to try it. Very easy to get it done. This will be the 15th mock scrape video that I have in my playlist on YouTube. I encourage you to not only check out my mock scrape playlist and the 15 videos and who knows how many more by the time you're viewing this, but I have lots of playlists, whether it's trail cameras, nocturnal bucks, advanced hunting strategies, food plots, making bedding areas, plantings, wildlife, plantings for deer, switchgrass. There are a lot of different types of playlists I have on my YouTube channel. I encourage you to look at those, find the topic you're interested in, and I think I cover all things whitetail. I hope you enjoy this little tip. This is a really important feature you can add on your property. It's something that if you watch my videos long enough, you'll see in almost all our B-roll of XS Trail Camera HD video, there's a mock scrape in the video. This is how we do it. I've been practicing this stuff for nearly 20 years as far as mock scrapes, and I've worked with hundreds of clients in their mock scrapes to see what's working best. So far, this is the best we've come up with. These steps are easy for you to implement before the hunting season begins, and I encourage you to let me know down below how they're working out for you this year and beyond.